But next we have filmmaker Charlotte Lucy and Karuna Charlotte Lucy, who will now tell you more about their film Lost and Found.
So about our film, the brief story follows a girl called Josephine who runs away from home after coming across some problems, but then realizes and then returns home.
We would like to say thank you for the people who supported us throughout the film. So thank you and enjoy.
Lost, left out, lonely. The shouting of my mother. I've never been able to make choices for myself. Finally, out here, I'm free. When I'm surrounded by a crowd of people, I can still feel so lonely. When I look out the window and see the colorful world in front of me, my life can still be dull gray. Lost, left out, lonely. Like the whole world is just a huge puzzle, and only my piece has nowhere to fit in it.
Checking. Put your phone down, please. James.
Yes.
Thanks, James. I'm Cassie.
Here. Thank you.
Josephine. May. May, that's enough, please. Hill. And Shelby. Well done, Shelby.
Where are you going?
It's a beautiful day outside, so I want to go out and take a walk.
I don't care if it's a beautiful day. I've told you before, your report grades are disgusting. Go back to your room and study.
I barely go out.
Go back to your room!
The shouting of my mother, the mean laughter of my classmates, the buzzing of the voices inside my head, telling me I'll never be accepted, wanted, perfect. I couldn't take it anymore. So I left, leaving the place called home. You might say it's irresponsible of me. It is irresponsible of me to leave everything behind me and just leave. All my worries, my troubles, my uncompleted responsibilities. But what is the meaning of life if everything that mattered was being responsible? Some people get happiness out of completing their jobs and responsibilities, but that's not me. I've never been able to make choices for myself, or I've never had the time to do what I truly want to do. All my life, I've been completing responsibilities in the favor of my parents, the school, and everyone else except for myself. For once, I get to go out into the wild and truly follow my heart. I get to follow where my own feet wants to take me, and it feels so good just to be able to connect to nature, to breathe in the sweet air of the grass and enjoy the wind brushing through my hair. You might say I'm lost, but weirdly, walking on these paths and these roads that my feet have never treaded on before, I feel a sense of belonging. Here in the wild, I feel a sense of strong identity that I've never been able to feel before. Finally, out here, I'm free. Sadly, wherever I go, nothing, not even nature, can fill my heart with the warmth that family can provide. Out here, I may feel more complete as a person, but parts of my life still seem to be missing. Maybe I'll never get the perfect, warm family I want, or the amazing, forgiving friends to be there for me. But I'll still have people who I love and care about. Even though they're not flawless human beings, they're still people who complete my life, who complete me as a person. So, I went back.
None who know how to feel.
They go on, like nothing has changed. They must not care. The thoughts whisper the lies in your brain. You try so, so hard, but you can't escape. You're trapped in your own skin. You're ugly, you're hated. So you mask it with a grin. You hate how you feel so much. Still instead, you feel nothing. Your insides feel numb. The whole world crumbling. You try to explain that your inside is broken, but they run, they hide, they turn the other way. They say, you're being foolish. It's only in your head. But what they don't know is, inside, you feel like you're dead. I'm sick of crying, tired of trying. I'm so done with pretending that I'm actually trying. Because what nobody knows is, inside, I feel like I'm dying.